Hi, this is Manisha and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to address one of that question which is asked by someone on my Instagram a few days back. That is how I create my invoices as a freelancer or as a small business owner. So I thought, why not create a video on it and show you the process, which software I use to create my invoices for my clients and for my business. So the software I use to generate my invoices for my clients, I use Zoho Invoices generator, and that is a free software. You can easily install it in your laptop or in your desktop, whether it is Mac or it is Windows, Microsoft. You can easily install it. And also, I will mention the link in the description box. You can install it easily. Even this software is available in Microsoft Play Store, as I can see. So you can easily download it from there as well. So without further delay, let me show you how my invoices looks like and how this software is so easy. It doesn't matter whether you have GST number or not. So without any further delay, let's get into it and let me show you the screen. For some privacy issues or some privacy reasons, I have edited some details, but still you will get some idea how my invoice looks like and how I create them. Okay, so let's get into it. At the right of this screen, you can see there is a option switch to GST version. If you have GST option, if you want to add GST number, then you can easily add it here, your GST number as well, and you can charge here to like what kind of GST you want to charge, CGST, SGST or CESS. I don't know what is CESS. If you are a freelancer and a small business owner and you don't have GST, then you can switch to the older tax version. That is so simple. I have mentioned Manisha Jain company here. You can write your company name, whatever your company name it is, and before that you can write your tagline, your name, whatever works for you and whatever you like. Below that you can mention your address, phone number, and of course your email ID. Okay, below that you will see bill 2. Keep it same as it is, and below that write client name, address and their country. You can write in 2 or 3 lines. You can mention your invoices number. Keep a track of invoices numbers, like if you have created invoice number 5 previous month, so make sure you continue the invoices number. So this month you have to create the invoice number 6. You can mention your invoice date, on which date you are creating this invoice. Due date is that when you want your client to make sure the payment is done. So that is your due date for your client. Here you can add your description, item description, like if you are a freelancer, I'm a graphic designer, so maybe I can write flyer. I have designed flyer. Okay, I have designed one flyer and I'm keeping the rate 500. So you can see that it is automatically calculated by the system. And if like I have created 2 flyer, as I will change the quantity, it will automatically changes the total amount. Okay, if I want to add another item like card and one quantity, let's keep it one quantity, and I'm charging 1000 rupees for this, you can see that subtotal is totally automatically done. So you don't have to worry about the calculation, you don't have to calculate it again and again. So that is easily calculative. And below that you can mention your bank details and in terms and conditions. And in terms and conditions I have mentioned, please make the payment by due date, jo ki hota nahi hai, but still you can add that. Below this, this is powered by Zoho Invoice and you would not be able to edit it, and that is okay. So that is how I easily create invoices, and this is super easy and handy tool which I have ever come across. Let me know in the comment section which software you use to create invoices. I hope you like this video and have a new learning from this video. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, please do take care of yourself. Bye.